Third lesson is the world needs preachers. The Lord gave the word. Great was the company of them that published it. I stand before you, beloved. When you read every headline and every talking head and every opinion, it's pushing out how you're to view what's going on in your nation and what the answer is. You know the answer. It's not in manifestos. It's not in Republicans gaining control. It's not in preachers. That is the answer. That is the answer for America. Preachers. There's a civil realm. God has given it. I'm all for it. But there's never any change. Let me just restate that. There's seldom any meaningful change without preachers. Preachers. Some of them are just ordinary. Men and women gossiping the gospel. They know whom they have believed. And they're persuaded. They're convinced of these truths. And so they'll teach them to their children. They'll instruct them even in the face of threat and all the social decadence of our day. But there is a need for preachers. The Lord teaches us this, does he not? Pray ye the Lord of the harvest. Send forth laborers into the harvest. America needs preachers. These preachers, men who are filled with the Spirit of God. Men who don't care what people think. They're governed by this one compelling, driving understanding. Woe is unto me if I preach not the gospel. Men who are gripped with a sense of the love of God. So they're not just going out there declaring truth. They love. They weep over souls. They have more interest in other people's lives than those individuals have in themselves. They see a world surrounded by people giving themselves to spiritual suicide, and they know the gospel is the answer. They give it out. The world needs preachers.